Right, I'm 30 now. I can only remember being off 2 times.
Oh, his memory's going as well, you'll have to climb off.
And both of them were when I was at school.
What school?
One when it was windy.
Why did you have time off? Because it was windy.
But to be honest, Carl, that lasted for 7 years.
Your time off at school. Why did you have time off because it was windy?
Were you windy or was it windy outside?
No, it was a really, it was like when-
Your auntie wasn't out of the window, was she?
Yeah. When the winds were bad in the 70s, and my mum said, oh-
I remember space hoppers and flares, I don't remember the winds being bad in the 70s.
Well, my mum just said, you might get blown into the road, so don't-
She had so much faith in you, didn't she? As a human being.
Is that why she got fired from the pie shop? I'm not coming in today, I might get blown into the road.
Oh god.
The funny thing it was, right, Steve, they had this thing going at school, because a lot of people used to wag it back then. Right?
Used to what?
Wag it, sort of not go in.
Yeah. Right.
Right. And they sort of tried to make it interesting for you by giving you a-
An education.
A certificate. Certificate if you did a full week.
Reward for the rest of your life with achievement. That sort of carrot.
And also, like, let you go home at 3 o'clock on a Friday. Right. If you'd done a full week and that.
Yeah.
So it was lovely weather all week. Then it just sort of changed on a Friday. And I got up and it was all windy.
It was windy for Friday and Sunday, isn't it?
don't, you know, if you don't want, don't go in because, you know, you might get blown into the road and that. So I said, all right, then I'll stay off. And,
so why did she told you to hold on to a fence or walk you there? What's this don't go out
immediately
and
give up?
I love this getting blown into the road. Is that based on your cats that kept getting blown into the road?
Well, so I got to school on the Monday, right? And the teacher said,
took
right,
you a long time.
Today, to punish you, you're the only one who wrecked the whole week, right? Everyone else came in, you didn't. So everyone else is going home at 3 o'clock today. But you're not.
Brilliant. Serves you right. And
I wasn't bothered though. It was great because I said, well, you'll have to stay with me, won't you?
And
it was great. So all I did for half an hour was doodle and stuff. It was great that afternoon.
Yeah.
And that was ages ago. That was like when I was about 8. And that's one of the times I was off ill.
Yeah. So it was, but that wasn't even ill. That was wind.
Yeah.
So growing up on this estate, and there was this woman about 4 houses down, right? It's a bit rough, right?
Didn't fancy her.
Oh, God, no. Right, but she had a
baby. Well, tell me about her first. I'm interested in this woman. Why was she?
It was a very-
She looked like a man in a dress.
I mean, I didn't grow up in a posh house or anything. And I'm not saying that if you live in a bit of a rough house, you're a bad person.
What did she look like?
But anyone can-
Tattoos?
Clean up.
Like Tony Green with a fag on.
They didn't clean up much, right?
Oh.
Which, even if you've not got a lot of money, you can still try and make a place look nice.
Yeah.
Right? But she didn't, and a kid used to take a horse into the house.
Sorry.
Whoa, Neddy.
What do you mean a kid used to take a horse into the house? Where did he get a horse?
Must have nicked it from somewhere. Must have.
Let's see, you see a horse to it. No.
What, is that from outside the saloon round the corner?
Yeah, was it just tied up with a bit of
leather?
Oh, that's great.
I've been looking for it. I'd been out.
Sorry, let me get this. This was before the lynching stopped or after.
Where'd he get a horse from? What do you mean he must have nicked it? His mum said, where'd you get that from? I bought it. All right then, but keep it out of the kitchen.
I don't want you going cattling rustling.
Where did he get a horse from, Carl? And how long did he have it for? Was he leading it or riding it? Mum, open the door, I can't stop!
I can't stop it! Open the patio door as well, Obi.
Looks like we got us a runaway! What do you mean?
I don't know, but the thing is, they couldn't afford to buy one because they're not cheap. So I'm just guessing. Maybe that's wrong of me. But I think-
He had a horse?
Yeah, right, so-
That's why the family didn't have any money, they'd spend it on the horse!
No, exactly!
That's what I'm saying, I don't think they would have bought it. So anyway-
Yeah, it's always to whisper, Carl, in case they're listening.
Yeah, and
they could be in the room next door.
It's not buying it, it's keeping it as well.
So I was like in the car with my dad, coming into the avenue, and you used to have to drive down it to turn round. And you know, sort of go back to our house.
You had the traditional method of transport,
And, the horse was in the lounge.
Reading a paper?
Just like walking around.
What?
And when I was doing it, I tried to earn myself some money once by flogging little flowers in plastic cups.
What?
This is genius. It just keeps coming. What do you mean you're trying to flog little flowers? What do you mean?
Wait. Let's play a record. Let's play a record and come back to this, because the story's going to just unravel and unravel. It's going to go for hours. Let's play a track,
Carl. It gets deeper and deeper. It's like an onion, isn't it?
We've created a whole world here where there's a man living with a horse.
Just walking around the lounge.
We're not coming from the West Country. I've never heard anything like that.
I just think of a big sort of like orange carpet and it's got a rediffusion telly and this horse going, I'm fed up in here.
Exactly.
This is really...
I am not taking the rubbish out again.
Yeah.
Right, play a record. Let's have Velvet Underground. We've got that lined up.
Oh,
yeah, the classic from the first album, I'm Waiting for the Man. Let's come back to the horse in a second.
Little flowers in pots. What do you mean?
Velvet Underground and Nico, which apparently peaked at a disappointing 171 in the US charts.
Think of that.
And that's obviously Lou Reed, Velvet Underground, and Waiting for the Man.
Yeah, great track. So, we were talking, we were doing White Van Man, and we got onto,
genetically modified babies, but
and
somehow
then Carl started telling a story about someone with a horse, and then he got onto, he was trying to make money selling flowers. Just do the flowers briefly.
Well, hang on, I just want to recap slightly. So there was a family, and who had the horse in the family?
It was...
Because you lived on an estate in Manchester.
The mother was a right pig, apparently. Well, I don't know if that's
you
relevant.
You don't need to go that far.
But you...
Well, what I'm trying to do is, like, make a picture for you so you understand
what a picture like? It is. Who did she look like?
Bit of a... And no disrespect to her. Bit like Pauline Quirk.
Quirky, yeah.
Right?
Okay. I knew you were going to say that. Yeah. I knew it was going to be Pauline. Did she have any tats?
I've never got that close to her.
Okay, alright.
So, and so who had the horse? Was this her son or her husband?
No, her daughter.
Her daughter had stolen a horse?
Yeah, from, I don't know where, there was a, I think it was some stables down the road or something.
And they kept the horse in the house with them?
They kept it in the house.
Did they get caught?
For long.
No.
So, and you said you were in the house one day and you saw the horse?
No, what happened was, I was, they did this thing at school about raising money for charity, right? For some local charity. And they said you can do anything to raise money, and they came out with all these ideas, and I thought, that's good.
What was the charity?
Well, forget, well I don't know, I thought, forget the charity.
Yeah, that's I'm just a good money making overweight.
So, you're a charity.
So, so I asked my mum for some, because she used to have a lot of flowers around the house.
Sure.
I said, can I just take some snippings off them, and I'll go and buy some plastic cups, and got some soil out of the garden, planted the bits of plants in them.
Yeah.
Got a tray.
Yeah.
Had about 25 plants on it, selling them for 25 pence each.
Excellent. Did you sell any?
Yeah, I sold loads.
You didn't just cut them and stick them in
the soil?
Yeah,
they wouldn't have survived. But I think people sort of thought, well, good on him for trying. But anyway, so I went round to theirs, because I thought their house could do with a bit of colour and stuff.
Yeah.
Because it's a bit rough. So, as I went-
The horse went, thank God for that breakfast. They've been feeding me kitty cat. Yeah.
So I got up to the door, and they opened the door, and it was one of them houses where- No carpet.
Yeah. A horse in the living room.
You know.
We've all been there.
And the horse was walking around the living room.
Oh.
I looked quite happy and everything because I always say that about animals.
Black Beauty was on.
Yeah. Well, think about it, right? If you were a horse, where would you rather be? In a little wooden hut with a load of hay or in like a house with a
central heating.
Three-piece suite and a telly and that.
Telly and that!
No, but I was saying this the other day.
And an Atari.
Right? Yeah, I didn't go to school much because me mum and dad had a caravan.
Right.
No need, is there? No need when you've got that sort of fun at home.
Yeah. I used to just go away for weeks.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that true?
Yeah, honestly.
Where'd you used to go?
Port Maddock.
But
and so you didn't go to school much?
No, I did, but not as much as everyone else.
No.
How many holidays were your parents having? Oh, what was their income that they could...
No, well, my dad used to work nights, and he used to travel back, because to Manchester from Wales, it wasn't that far.
And to Wales?
He used to do four on and four off, so me and my mum were, like, loving it.
But what's Port Meredith?
Port Maddock.
Port Maddock?
Down the road from Port Merion, where they filmed The Prisoner.
Right.
Also, so that's cleared up for me.
Yeah,
location-wise.
So what did you do then? You were in this little two-berth caravan on the back of a... Cortina estate.
Right.
Well, what was it? What was the car? I want the, what was
Granada,
it?
Ford Granada.
What are we talking? 1980?
Yeah, 82, 83, 84,
85. Okay. And you in the car, down there, down there, park up.
Yeah.
What was it? What was Port Meredith?
Port Maddock.
Port Maddock.
I remember Ruth.
It's just,
oh, yeah.
It's just a holiday camp.
Yeah.
And at an arcade and a beach. I was loving it.
Yeah. But so of the 52 weeks of the year, let's assume, I don't know how many weeks you take off normally for holidays anyway. Let's just say, I don't know, you go to school 45 weeks of the year, maybe? Generally, most kids?
No.
A bit less than that.
42.
How many weeks would you say you actually spent in school?
Well, how many weeks do you have off for summer?
Well, we'll work that out. That's what
about
we mean.
Six off for summer, about three for Easter, about three for Christmas.
Put it this way, I'm surprised I'm not Welsh, to be honest.
Right.
So I was there more than was in Manchester.
Did the school authority not come and check you out?
No, they didn't.
Didn't get Manchester, I suppose, they didn't care, did they?
Not really.
Yeah.
They're lucky you turned up at all. What did you just turn up for the last day when you could take in your best toy? Did you know that when you could take in any game?
Just play with everyone else's. Why break my stuff?
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's cool. This does answer a lot, the fact that you spent most of your time on the beach as a kid.
Teachers were no good at my school. We were talking about it yesterday.
So you were teaching them a lesson by going off in the summer. Yeah. Anyway. And did you go to university?
No.
Did you go to sixth form or college?
No.
When did you leave school?
When I was about 15.
Right. What, you just went on holiday and didn't come back?
I just got a job early, didn't I?
Where was it? Port Maddock?
No, I was a printer. BM Print in Trafford Park. Have you ever seen, like, a bald pet?
No.
It's weird.
What do you mean?
Because my mum, we had a cat, we used to get through loads of cats because we lived there.
Oh, God, it's starting early today, isn't it?
What do you mean?
It's only 10 past one. What are you doing?
No, running a restaurant?
We lived on.
Oh, God, what do you mean?
No, we lived on, like, a main road.
Oh, yeah.
Right? So we used to get through a lot of them. They'd kept saying, you know, stop wasting money, you know, it's not
stop wasting money, not wasting cats.
Right, so, anyway, we had this cat that was ill all the time. And,
it's just bag of nerves, probably.
Yeah, Malingra. Yeah, I'm terrified.
I'm going to which house?
Wrong. Oh, God, bloody hell. Wrong.
Don't let me go to the Pilkingtons.
And it, for some reason, it kept being sick all the time.
Right? Yeah, that is nerves. That's definitely nerves.
So, my mum kind of thought, oh, I've had enough of this, and she shaved it.
Whoa. Now, I know you're not vets in your family, but what correlation did your mum think there was between it being sick and shaving it?
Because it kept being sick, and it was a pain to wash, because it kept getting
caught. So she wanted a dry wipe cat.
So.
Why didn't you just varnish it? What?
It's weird, so now
he's cold and sick.
No, but not all of it. She left sort of the back half, but sort of from its waist, sort of.
I love that shaving because it's sick on itself. Yeah.
And it was the weirdest looking thing. I mean, normally I like cats. I'm always like giving yours a stroke on the head and that.
Yeah.
But as soon as she did that, it was like, oh.
Yeah.
Poor
can't
thing.
Touch it. And then.
So now it's sick, cold, and hated.
Yeah.
I love Carl.
It must have, I mean, the other cats must have been taking the mick out of it constantly. It's just making things worse. Did it get, I'm hoping that it got run over and was put out of its misery.
No, I think it got alright, that one. Or is that the... Yeah, it did get run over. It did.
Oh, God. Oh. Oh, dear.
How many cats do you say you've got through?
I'd say whilst I was living at home, I mean, it's still on the increase even though I'm not there. So, whilst I was there, probably five.
God!
Wow.
Oh!
Yeah. And were you upset each time, or you just got used to it?
It's one of them things, isn't it? Like I've said before, when you first see something, it's a bit of a shock. Do you know what I mean? It's like the elephant man or whatever.
Yeah.
First time you see him, it's that sort of, oh, look at that. Did I tell you the time when, the doctor said I was gonna die?
All right, keep talking.
Right, ages ago, must have been about 15, right? And, at lunchtime there was this... We used to have a choice of stuff to do at lunchtime, right? We used to have, like a burger place that had an arcade machine in it, right? So we used to go there and play on that and have a burger. Or, there was this baker's, right, that my mum worked at, and, did great cakes and stuff, right? So, she used to, like, bring some home and that, but she couldn't always bring them home every night because, you know, they'd cost money and she used to get them for free. And they used to say they'd rather chuck them away than give them to the staff because there's a chance that the cream might be off.
Right.
Right, so they used to chuck them round the back.
So I used to go around the back with my mate and eat a load.
Brilliant.
Scavengers, yep. Eating out of bins.
No, it was really, it wasn't out of bins, they were still in trays, but they just stacked them up near the bins, right? So this got out, I mean, it used to be a chocker. Once the school found out, everybody used to go there and it'd be like, well, have a cake.
The headmaster coming through, fighting the kids off.
Right, so I'd have, you know, you'd just eat, I don't know, 6 jam donuts or something, and then you'd spend your dinner money on the arcade machine.
Brilliant.
Right? So it was a good afternoon, really, right? So you'd do that, and this one day I must have had 6 or 7, jam donuts, a few Congress tarts,
What's a Congress tart?
Just, I love them, it's me, I can't get them in London, right? So I'd have some of them.
And if anyone can get a Congress tart, for Carl in London, please let him know.
So anyway, this day, that was just a normal day, do you know what I mean? You'd, twice a week, you'd have a load of cake.
In your life, yeah.
Yeah, a so normal day in your life. Were the frog boys there with the webbed hands and the big heads? So, and the horse in the settee, yeah.
But the day after, one of these days, I had really bad cramp in my belly. Right? Yeah. I was like, in agony, could hardly walk, so I said to my mum, oh.
You could hardly stagger to the free cakes.
So, I was in absolute agony. I said, I think, I don't like doctors, but you'll have to get a doctor in, because I don't know what it is, I can't walk. She gets the doctor around, I won't say his name, but he said, well, doesn't look like he's got long left.
Blimey.
So I was a bit like, hang on a minute, I've only had a few cream donuts.
Yeah.
My mum was panicking.
Sure.
He went, my dad came in from work, she said, oh, something's really bad with Carl, I think it's serious, he's, you know, the doctor's only got long left. So he said, what, he said that and just left? So he said, yeah. So I'll have to call him then. So he called him up, said, what's all this about, you know, Carl hasn't got long left, how long's he got? So he goes, oh, I was only messing. He's just had some bad cream. Can you believe that?
Well, the thing is,
I like the fact your mum didn't ask any questions.
I know.
She didn't go into detail. Can you explain more, doctor? No, I got a shoe off.
No, but she doesn't.
I don't want to diss you or your family, but I imagine if I was there, I'd have known the doctor was joking. Yes. That's all I'm saying. I mean, I sound very arrogant there, but I imagine he went, what's he been doing? I had about 6 cream donuts. Oh, right. Oh, wow. He hasn't got long to live then. I'll see you later. Yeah. That's what I think the doctor did.
Yeah. Just like the idea your mum just let him go.
Yeah.
Terrified, thinking, well, I'm not going to probe him. He's that's it then.
Dad comes in. Hi, honey, I'm home. Anything happened? Doctor said Carl's going to die and then left.
Go on.
Watching a programme yesterday. And it was about these Japanese snow monkeys. And it was all about how animals learn things that aren't instinctive, particularly sort of primates, because they see other people doing it, and they start a culture. And they can pinpoint when these monkeys, when one monkey first went down and got in the hot water springs and stayed there because it was hot, and the others copied them, and now it's part of almost a culture, you know, that won't be handed on because it's not instinctive, but has to be learnt each time. And, you know, and they groom as normal, like other monkeys, right, but they're really intelligent, and, obviously, the reason they groom other people, other monkeys, is because they eat the mites, but also, the monkeys have learned they like being groomed, okay, so they showed this one monkey, it went to a deer, okay, and it was grooming this deer to get its mite off it, right, but then it didn't eat it, it held it in its hand, it went over to a monkey, put the mite on itself to show the monkey it had a mite, and got a free grooming.
That's extraordinary.
That's extraordinary.
That is extraordinary.
Because it gave up the food, knowing that if you put one there, this monkey would look for mites on it, yeah, and it would get a free grooming, and it was like having a little massage. What do you think of that?
It's not bad, I've got some better stuff coming up later.
On monkey news. On the official monkey news.
Yeah, do you see what mine though, mine's true.
I mean, that's an extraordinary.
It actually happens. It's social behaviour amongst primates. So I saw it. It was, you know.
Did it rob a bank, Rick, at any time?
It didn't rob a bank, and it didn't open a hairdresser's.
So that's what you're letting. That's what you're letting yourself
down. It's not quite good enough, is it? My monkey news.
No, I got some.
See the difference where I named the species, explained it slightly, told you an interesting fact, as opposed to there's this monkey, right? And,
look at him looking at you.
Yeah.
He's not interested, Rick. Can I tell you now? Can I try and describe for people the face that Carl has? I'll tell you what it's like. It's like if you draw, some eyes, a nose, and a mouth on a balloon, and then inflate it to about half full. That's what Carl's face looks like. That's what his head looks like. It looks like a face you've drawn on a balloon. Very small, the rest of the head huge.
It's just that today I'm a bit tired, right? That's one thing.
Why are you a bit tired?
I just haven't been sleeping, right?
Why not?
I don't know, I've got a lot going on in the head.
Oh, if this would be like The Simpsons, if we could actually look in there, there would be two monkeys grooming you.
Yeah. Plus, you've been talking about, like, stuff that I can't relate to and that, so I'm...
What, writing poetry?
Like what?
Reading books.
Yeah, what? Doing poetry and stuff. I never did any of that.
What did you do?
Well, at school they didn't bother. They tried to get us to write more, right?
Right.
By,
giving you a pen?
No, they used to give us these school diaries.
Yeah.
Little red book. And it was a way that they kept an eye on what you were doing out of school hours.
Right.
Right, so some kids would write down, you know...
Stole a bike.
Yeah.
Burned a house down.
Yeah.
But when I was at school, around that sort of 12 age, I didn't get up to much. You have no money, there's nothing you can do. So every night it was the same thing. I'd get home and I'd have to go to the shop, right, and get some potatoes and some bread every night. Right, and I kept taking this into school.
Sorry, what was it, Dublin in the 17th century?
Yeah.
What do you mean every day you went to the shops and got potatoes and bread?
That's kind of what I had to get all the time. That's
what we had. Why? What did you have? Chip sandwiches?
Yeah.
Right, and, so you went to the, yeah, you went there.
So I kept,
with
I kept
your hoop
putting
and
that.
Stick.
I kept putting that in a diary, you know, every night saying, went to UFAS, that was the name of the shop. Yeah. UFAS.
What is it, U or U?
Like H-U-G-H.
H-U-G-H, yeah. Oh, that was his name?
UFAS, right. Right. Used to go there, get the potatoes and
bread
and that.
I have to find someone who's named a shop after themselves. I'm not going to say what we sell, it's named after me or nothing, or am I opening?
Mainly potatoes and bread. Yeah. White sliced loaves, King Edward's.
And the teacher used to always say, just write something different in there, make something up. Because,
yeah,
like, you know, Monday, Tuesday, all the way through to Friday, every night, it was just, went to UFAS.
Went to UFAS?
So you sort of, you think...
Are you sure it wasn't an advert? Sure he wasn't paying you to say, get my name in the book?
Yeah.
The only time that it changed, and she said, oh, that's made it a bit more interesting, was when it was my birthday, and I had to buy a cake.
Potatoes and a cake?
And she said, oh, that's good.
Yeah.
That was my 13th birthday. My mum said, I got home from school, she said, oh, you're 13 today. Teenager, big turnover. Go and get a cake.
That's your experience of writing?
No, what? Well, no, that's your experience of your 13th birthday. Oh, by the way, you're 13 today, go and get a cake.
Yeah.
Brilliant. Big surprise? Was it a big surprise?
yeah.
That is brilliant. So, I love it.
That's the only sort of writing.
What, and they never asked you to write essays or stories?
Did you never write a story or a poem or a...
The stories I did earlier on were, you know, you made them up, but it was that thing that I'd always end them with, and an alarm went off and it was all a dream.
Every single one of them.
Yeah. But they didn't, I mean, it was a bit of a...
I bought some potatoes and some bread, then I woke up and it was all a dream.
No. Then I went to shops and bought some potatoes and bread. But did you ever do anything that write about an adventure when you were a spaceman, or you were in, you know, you were a cowboy, or... No? Yeah,
all the teachers, like, had scams going on, so, like, in English, right, you'd go in there, and the teacher would say, right, what we're doing today is, got a load of brochures from Thompson, but they say, like, 1983 on the front, so I've got a load of stickers here that say 1984, let's see how many you can do in half an hour.
You are joking.
Did you go to school with Oliver Twist?
Sorry, you are joking.
I'm not, that's what they did. So the teacher must have been getting, like, a freebie or something for helping them out.
You, is this...
Honestly, yeah, that's what it's...
That is fantastic.
They were all after it, they were all
other than Mr. Fagan, you had...
Yeah. And then when they saw Karate Kid, they had every kid washing their car, going, wax on, wax off, hurry up.
Yeah.
I'm teaching you something, wax on, wax off, paint the fence.
So I'm just saying, you know, that's why I'm a bit quiet, because you're talking about stuff I can't
relate to.
And why didn't you sleep last night?
I'm just... I haven't slept well since I was about 12. Do you sleep well, Steve?
Wait, you can't let that go! I haven't slept well since I was 12. What do you mean?
Do you know, like, a proper... I used to love going to bed as like a kid.
Yeah.
Whereas now it's like, oh, am I going to sleep tonight? And I sort of wake up about four times.
Right.
Whereas when you're a kid, I remember really loving like, go out of bed. There was one time where I actually laughed myself to sleep because I couldn't believe me luck.
What do you mean you laugh yourself?
I've never had it when you're really tired and you get in bed and the pillars feel.
Yeah, it's all cold. Yeah.
And it's like, I can't believe this.
Yeah.
And it happened twice. Once when I just went to bed and I was really looking forward to it. And also when I helped my dad out once, like through the night, he worked at this paper company, right? And I helped him out and I got in at about 4 a.m. with him. Got in bed and I just was like, I was laughing my head off. I had to put the pillow over my head. Because I couldn't believe me luck. Like, I was like, oh, this is great, this. I'm going to sleep.
I just have to say, life up north is so extraordinary.
No, but you must be the easiest kid in the world to please. No wonder she knew she could just go get a cake. It's sort of like, what was he expecting her to say? He were expecting an extra hour in bed, yeah. But we got him cake as well.
Any supper. Brilliant.
Brilliant, yeah. Your own bed. How long was it before you got your own? What did you used to do before? Just some straw in the corner?
No, it's just that thing of when you're really tired and...
And do you ever do this with Suzanne, then? Do you ever laugh yourself to sleep with her?
No, that's what I mean.
She can't sleep because you're chuckling away.
I don't know what's up with me. I've got a lot going on.
Carl was in Heat this week, and they mentioned that he does this thing on Sky. What is it?
It was... This thing with Richard Bacon, some program about watching telly, and you just talk about what you're watching, mm-hmm. and that.
And he was annoyed, because he said because his parents are out, and so he's not doing it. He's not going to turn up, because they mentioned it in Heat.
And so his parents might watch?
Yeah.
Why are you worried about that?
I don't like him watching stuff, do I? I told you. It dates back to when I did Little Donkey at school. Sure. I don't want people watching me.
What's that? Just renew us on Little Donkey? What happened?
It was just, you know, I was there to play the drums and that, in We Three Kings.
Mm-hmm.
I was loving it, you know. I got a bit carried away.
How old were you?
About 13. Yeah. Right?
Really?
Probably.
Yeah.
About 10, no, about 10 probably. Innit?
Yeah.
Six.
Between 6 and 30. Where old were you? What school were you at?
okay, you were playing Little Donkey.
Yeah.
No,
but it was one of them schools where everyone sort of was in the same one. Do you know what I mean?
Oh, a Manchester school.
Just what the one do you classroom. Mean?
Well, it's like...
Sweeping chimneys in the day and then 1 hour of learning. Yeah. What are you talking about? What school were you at? Was it infants, junior or secondary?
They didn't really do that. It was one way.
What do you mean? You did that? They still have to abide by the laws of the land in Manchester.
No, but it was a lot more... Like you had infants, but you also had, like, the older lot. There's kids there... When you're in the younger year and that, you'd see kids and you go, is that-
Talk English and use terms that people do when they're talking about schooling.
I don't even want to talk about this.
No, how old were you?
I'm guessing maybe 6 or 7 or 8.
So you went from 13 to 6?
Yeah, but like I say, it's hard to remember because-
Imagine if you were giving evidence in a trial.
Yeah. How old were you? I don't know.
Yeah.
I mean, I can't really narrow it down other than 7 years either way.
You know, theoretically, he could get called up for jury service. Right, you're on-
A lot of mates who I had didn't have enough money to go on holiday, and they just get a present for the summer holiday.
I would like,
Of course, they got an education, so it swings.
Yeah, but Carl, the thing is with Carl is, right, I want to give him gifts.
Yeah.
I want him to be have the loveliest Christmas ever. I want him to go pony trekking. Mm. Do you know what I mean? I want to just-
Scared of horses.
So many things we don't know about, Carl.
Fell off one out of fate. And the woman didn't know what to do. She couldn't handle the horse. It was running off. I was hanging underneath, getting a kick in the head.
No. Really?
Now hang on, what age were you? This could explain a lot.
I was about 6.
That makes a lot of sense. Oh, I think we've got to the bottom of it here.
Oh no, got kicked in the head by a horse, lived in a caravan, and had to live in Wales half the time.
Uh-oh.
Oh. Then no wonder this is your favourite time of the week. Do you look forward to this all week, these 2 hours?
It's alright. My mate, right, he was religious.
Uh-huh.
And I'm not, really. But...
No, I mean, you believe in ghosts, though, and shadows pushing people off bikes. But go on.
But it's the same time, I think I told you once before that I went to the church with this lad because I swore and he said he was going to tell me dad.
Yeah.
I'm effing and jeffing. So he said, if you're going
to... Effing and
chippy.
Is that how they get people to church nowadays?
I love that one kid that, yeah, he hasn't quite got the idea of the protection game. There's nothing in it for him. Either you turn to religion or I tell your father.
Right, so I went to church with him and that, and then the next week he said, I know that was rubbish and you didn't enjoy it. It's when I got kicked out for messing with a tennis ball in the pews, right?
I don't think we've heard that, but I don't think we can possibly go into that now.
Summed it up.
Yeah.
So,
Well, come on, we'll come back to that.
You had a tennis ball and some pubes.
No, in the pews.
In the pews, right. Yeah. But anyway, so I went there and I said, I don't think much of this church thing, it's a bit boring.
Sorry, and so you went to church and you ended up in the Crusades.
No, the it's called the Crusaders. What it is, it's meant to be the fun part of religion for kids.
Uh-huh. Right.
And my mate said, oh, you want to come along, it's, you know, you go on a Friday night and do it on a Sunday as well.
Brilliant.
So I went on the Friday night, it was brilliant. They had Sabutio, played table tennis in this dead big old house.
And what do they do at the end? Say, I hope you enjoy yourself, remember God gave you all this.
Well, it's sort of, you know, enjoy the simple things in life. You don't need computer games, you can play table tennis and, and talk with your friends and blah blah blah. So yeah, that's alright.
I think you'd be happy in a Young Offenders Institute. You get to clean the toilets there.
But
as
don't forget, Carl, I think God invented Nintendo too.
Right. Well, anyway, so that was alright. I loved it on the Friday.
Yeah.
And my mate said if you go for 4 weeks, four weeks in a row without missing a day, you get a free badge.
And, salvation.
Oh, I don't like all this sort of being stuck in stuff. Do you know what I mean?
That's
pretty heading out of school.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It's like, oh, every day. Yeah. Right. So anyway, so you've got to come again on Sunday, so I thought, well, we'll have another game of table tennis, it'll be alright.
Yeah.
So anyway, I go on the Sunday.
Who was this servant of God?
Right. I go on the Sunday, it's like a totally different club. There's no table tennis.
That's how they trick you.
No Sabutio.
Yeah.
They start handing out Bibles.
Oh. And it's like a timeshare thing.
Hang on a minute, right?
They trick you.
So I didn't go again on Sundays, I used to just go on the Friday.
Just go on the Friday, brilliant. I'm amazed no one else saw through that.
Well, the thing is, there used to be loads there on the Friday, so they won't even notice if I'm not, like, that I'm not showing up on a Sunday. So anyway, carried on, it was
just this kid and the vicar.
Oh, I love that. You got one over on the church.
So I was loving it, right, playing table tennis and that, on a Sunday, they found out where I live, and the head fella started coming round, knocking on the door.
It's God.
He's everywhere, Rick.
Why did he knock?
The fella.
For likeness.
The fella who, like, ran the club, he started coming around knocking on the door, and I saw him coming up the path and I said to me, mum, oh, it's the fella from the Crusaders. Yeah. She didn't even know what I was
She thought you were off nicking hubcaps and stealing cars.
She didn't have a clue what I was talking about.
You've been going to church?
I don't believe it.
Little bleeder.
That's not how we brought you up.
So, I said, look, just tell him I'm not in. And she had to keep doing this, and they were coming round every Sunday to try and make me, like, go on a Sunday. It was really important that I went and that I was abusing the system and all this. Anyway, I didn't go, and then-
Why didn't they just tell you on the next time you turned up on a Friday?
Yeah.
No, well, because there was so many people there on a Friday, you just get mixed in the crowd.
Right. Yeah.
It was jammed. It was well popular on a Friday.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? But anyway, on one of the Sundays, it was quiet for a bit, and they stopped coming round. So I thought, right, I can go out again, right, on a Sunday, because I used to avoid hanging around the house. In
what case sort of reign of terror is this?
It's incredible.
Right. So I thought,
it's like the Spanish Inquisition.
So I thought, great, they forgot about me.
Yeah.
Everything, I can carry on in sort of normal life now.
Yeah.
And I was playing out in the avenue, fella comes round.
Oh.
And he goes, there you are, you know, you're always busy on a Sunday. You enjoy Fridays and that, don't you? I was like, yeah, yeah. He goes, well, come on, you've got to come with me. And I couldn't get out of it.
No.
You know what I mean, it's like, what could I say?
Charlie says.
Right?
Yeah.
So, anyway, he nearly killed me in a car crash. So that was the excuse I used next time. He had a Mini, right? And he was driving us there, and he hit the curb, nearly sort of turned over the Mini.
God.
And it was like three of us in the back. So, I said-
Is that a record?
So, next time-
Or was it a joke?
Next time he came round to pick us up, I said, look, really enjoyed it and that. I said, but ever since that journey, I really, you know, I don't want to get in the car with you again, because- It scared me a bit. I said, all right then. I didn't have to go again.
That's all right, isn't it?
That's extraordinary.
Yeah.
He almost killed you in a car crash.
It's a parable. Thank God no one was hurt.
Mm. Yeah.
I remember that.
Your life moves in incredible ways.
Yeah.
Rather like God.
Yeah. So, they're probably around there now, aren't they? Going, is he coming tomorrow? So, would you like to start on your, to Steve, because I've heard all these.
Well, we won't do them all.
Well, we'll start off with the Mr. Freeze. Tell Steve the story of Mr. Freeze. This is the first time he nearly died.
This is the most serious of the lot, really. So, what it was, do you know, like, I don't know if your mum and dad did the same thing, but, like, they'd do the weekly shopping on like, a Friday.
Yep.
So when you got to Thursday, there wouldn't be much stuff left in the cupboard. It'd just be like, you know, your Jacob's crackers and stuff like that. So when they'd been to the supermarket and they came back, I was like, you know, what's that saying? Like a pig in, you know, I loved it. It was like loads of food coming in, loads of biscuits.
What is that saying?
He nearly said pig in shit.
Right.
Is that the saying?
Yeah.
Right. So, so yeah, all this food comes in.
Thank God he didn't.
Otherwise he'd have been in trouble.
That's true enough.
Because he's culpable for our actions, because he's the producer. So technically, that twat's in charge. Go on.
Right, so anyway, so there's loads of food, and I'm like, oh yeah, look at this, and chocolate biscuits, and, you know, penguins and stuff.
Bacon.
So, bacon.
Just in case, you never know.
So, so anyway, my mum and dad's putting the food away. Me and our kid are like, he's already grabbed something, gone back upstairs.
It's like feral children. It's like a quest for fire. And then they run upstairs. What did you sit under the bed, gnawing at some sort of pig's trotter?
So I saw, do you remember Mr. Freeze Pops?
I do, yeah. So, well, they're kind of like popsicles, icicles.
Yeah, but really long, like a foot long, right? Yeah. So I thought, I'll have one of them, so I grabbed it.
Went for the nutritious stuff first.
Absolutely.
And like, my mum and dad are putting this stuff away and what have you. And I rip it open and knock it back. Right, straight away, just right back like
swallow
that.
It,
right
down
it. But it went down the wrong way, right?
What, so I what was down like, your shirt?
So I was like, oh God, I can't breathe. And my mum and dad didn't even know what I'd ate. Do you know what I mean? I ate it so quick.
Yeah.
And I'm sort of tapping my mum on the back, going, she's going, oh God, you know, he's choking again, because I was always choking. If it was one thing, I don't know if I've got like a small throat, but I mean, even Ricky knows, I can't drink that much, can I?
Yeah. Do you
know,
or eat pebbles.
I'm not a quick drinker, I'd always, I think I'm scared of like, swallowing stuff.
Yeah.
And it was like bottle tops and mint imperials and stuff, I was always choking on stuff.
Jeez.
So anyway, she's going, oh God, what's he picked up on that now?
Drop it!
And so,
hit his nose with a stick.
So I was going, oh, I'm choking. At this point, my dad had like, I think he'd put his share away, you know, his food away, and he'd gone.
His share! I love it!
Yeah. He'd gone to watch like, Winner Takes All or whatever, in a lounge, and I was in the kitchen, and I was starting to like, just, I didn't care anymore, do you know what I mean? I just got to that point where I wasn't struggling anymore.
You just thought, I'm done for.
I just was like, falling to the ground. And my mum's going, you know, get in here, I think it's serious. My dad comes in and sort of starts shouting at me, saying, that's what you get for being greedy. He didn't even know what I'd eaten.
Well, it was the moment to teach you a lesson, certainly.
So he's there like that, and my mum's going, oh, look at him, and my lips were going purple, and my eyes were rolling into the back of my head.
You look like Marilyn Manson.
And, so anyway, she grabbed me from behind and did that fireman thing.
The Heimlich manoeuvre.
Yeah. And, you know, winded me. And it came up, and I was all right.
What, the whole popsicle came flying back out?
You see, that's what I don't understand. Because there was nothing there.
No, just a little bit. No, it swells up, doesn't it? Because it irritated it. So it went down your sort of like, your epiglottis, it went down the wrong way. Like, it went into your air canal instead of your throat. And it sort of spasms, and that's the fear. You've just got to calm it down and relax.
So in time, I would have been all right anyway.
Well, no, you might have.
So
the weird thing is, like, for like 3 days after that, I felt like a sort of a special person. I went to school.
Unless I'm saying nothing.
I did full days.
A special needs person.
Yeah. I went to school the next 3 days after that. I didn't like wag it or anything. I did full days.
I love that. 3 days, turn over.
Yeah, exactly. After 3 days, you thought, screw it.
Yeah, well, did a quick history exam.
But have you ever had that where you've like felt like I've been given another chance here?
Mm. Right, next one. Weird. That's popsicle. That's popsicle hell, we call that. Right, next one.
Which one's the next one?
Oh, what about your paper round?
Right.
Can I ask very quickly, did your life flash before your eyes like they say it did?
No, I just sort of went really calm and like, I'm ready for this now.
Right.
I wasn't bothered, you know what I mean?
You had no regrets?
No. No. It was weird. Just really weird.
Yeah.
But anyway, the paper round one. Paper round, I'd still say it's the best job I've ever had.
And he means it!
No, I really enjoyed it. It's like, you know, you don't have to work with anyone else. Right? So you make your own rules.
Just think of that.
You know, you're sort of
around. You're spreading information.
Well, yeah.
To people.
Yeah,
vital information.
Giving a service. Yeah. And no one else is around, you know, you can just do what you want and think about stuff whilst you're cycling around on your bike. It's really good.
Yeah.
So, so anyway.
Imagine the stuff he's thinking about when he's riding around.
I know, I can't. Oh, so getting in the head of a salamander.
So anyway, I loved it. And even though I only got like 50p a day, right, no matter what the weather was like and stuff, I used to get up at 4:30 and, go and do the round. And,
why'd you get up at 4:30?
Because I wanted to watch the Pink Panther at 5:30, so I wanted to get me paper round done.
I said, why didn't you watch the Pink Panther?
And then,
he went, oh, I can't sit there thinking I've got my paper round to do.
He'll ruin it for him.
Yeah. So is it a good job or not?
So 4:30 I was up and about, and this morning it was like winter, really bad winter, bad snow, you know, freezing cold, really windy and all that. And my mum said to me before I went to bed, she said, don't be getting up tomorrow, I'll give you the 50p. I said, it's not about the 50p. So, you know, people want the papers and stuff. So,
conscientious.
So anyway, I went to bed thinking, you know, that's it. I've told her I'm still going, so, you know, whatever. Go to sleep, get up in the morning, and, put all my kit on. And I used to have layers of clothing on because it was really cold. I had, like, a big anorak on with the fur on. I had, like, waterproof pants, and I got my paper round bag. And, I went downstairs to get out and tried to open the door, and it was locked. Oh, God, so she'd locked it so I couldn't go out, so I'm searching around the house looking for the keys. She must have hid them somewhere. I thought, oh, God, you know, I've got the papers to do. So I thought, how can I get out? So I went upstairs, climbed out of the bathroom window.
God.
Right, and to try and jump out of the bathroom window onto the porch. But the problem was, I had so much gear on, I was like the Michelin man. So I could hardly move as it is.
Yeah.
And I'm trying to get out the window, and I'm like, try to stretch down like that, get my foot on the porch, and my bag got caught on like the hook of, do you know like how you have a hook so you can put the window open?
Right, yeah.
The little arm goes on. My bag had got caught on that. I was holding onto the wall and my foot on the thing so I couldn't sort of pull it away in case I pulled it away and then fell on my head.
Yeah.
So I'm stuck there.
Dangling.
Dangling. My dad comes back from working nights.
Yeah.
He thinks I'm a burglar.
Gets out his gun.
So, so he's shouting and stuff, going mad and going, Dad, it's me. And he had to give us a hand using a...
He's heard that wily trick in Manchester before.
He had to help me using a washing prop thing, a big stick.
What did he do?
Well, he said, just hold on for your dear life, and I'll sort of push the paper bag off the hook.
Why didn't he go upstairs and sort it out?
It was at that point where I was in the middle, there was nothing you could do, do you know what I mean?
Mm,
it's at that point where you've just got to make a decision.
Yeah.
And by the time you go upstairs, who knows what might have happened.
Sure.
Do you know what I mean? You've got to act there and then, not messing around.
Yeah, yeah.
So-
And you could hear downstairs, now here he is, the Pink Panther.
Yeah.
Dad!
Hurry up!
Ever so pink! Oh.
So that was close to death, because I must have been about 30 foot in the air.
Yeah.
And I would have, you know, that would have been nasty if I fell to the concrete paving, sure. So.
Well,
and,
there's more to come. Should we play a record and come back to this? Because he's got more.
Oh yeah, no, there must be one of them where you did fall on your head. This is the one I'm waiting for. There's gotta be one. That would explain so much.
Yeah.
I nearly did, nearly broke me back.
Jeez.
Once. My dad said I better can't kick me out. And I said I better can. And,
I don't remember this, you didn't tell me this one.
You know, better can what?
I was in the garden, summer's day, and it was that era when, like, doing Kung Fu and all that was really popular.
Sure.
And I was like messing about in the garden, punching the tree and stuff. And my dad said,
what a kid he must have been.
My dad said, I bet you can't kick your height.
Kick your height? What, yeah, you mean kick as high as yourself?
Yeah, so I must have been like 5 foot or something then. And I said, of course I can. So I bet you can't. But instead of doing it on the grass, I did it on like the concrete bit. Kicked it, actually did it. I went, there you go. But then like, get my foot down quick enough and land
on
the
back. Oh, you paused to say, there, I've done it.
Yeah.
As opposed to putting your foot back on the ground.
And landed on my back, and I'd still get back trouble now.
Do you?
Because he say that, don't they?
So, to cut a long story short, he gave me about 4 or 5 near-death experiences, and he went, and the whole point of this, he went, so that's why I think I'm going to die of something horrible, like cancer. And I went, why? He went, right, you ready for this?
Yeah.
He said, well, I don't check my balls. Wait. He said, I don't like the feel.
Carl, have you ever logged on to Friends Reunited? It was the site that everyone was talking about last year.
No.
Are you aware of the concept?
I've heard about it, but there's no one from school who I'd want to see again, really.
So basically, for those that don't know, you have to log on to his website, and then you can help. It helps you track down your old schoolmates if they've also logged on and stuff. And we sort of took the liberty, really, of looking on the Friends Reunited site and typing in your school and trying to track down any of your old mates. We didn't get in touch with any of them. Don't worry.
We didn't do that.
We're not going to surprise you with them now.
No.
But I was just interested to know, like, some of your thoughts on some of the names that I could run past you. I mean, these are people from your year. Just tell me if you recognise the names. Alison Birch.
Think I remember.
What's your thought? What's your thoughts on it?
Don't
be libelous.
Don't say. Don't be like no.
No. Posh probably did pretty well in history and that.
Sarah Morris.
God, yeah. Remember.
Go on. You're grinning. What's the thought? Go on.
No, just she was all right. She was a popular one.
What does that mean?
She was nice.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. What about Darren Buckley?
He was one of my best mates.
Was he really?
Yeah.
Seriously?
Yeah.
What do you reckon he's doing now? Do you still keep in touch?
When my mum and dad were still in Manchester and they had a butty shop, he used to go in because the Buckies was next door.
I love the way he paints a picture. If you do this in your history exam, Carl, you will walk it.
Go on. So your parents had a butty shop, there was a Buckies next door.
Yeah, and he liked having a bit of a gamble, so he used to, I think he works for some insurance company.
Do you think that his fiancée Beth knows he's got a gambling problem? Yeah. Or his two-year-old son, Lewis.
No.
Yeah, they live in Cheadle Home.
Hume.
Cheadle Hume.
He must be doing well.
He's still supporting the Blue Army and frequents the shrine on a fortnightly basis.
Funny thing with him is, right, when I used to stay over at his house, and his dad was a copper, and I remember his dad came down and said, right, I want to see you two. I was like, oh, God, what's happened? And got us round the table. He said, do you know much about drugs? So we were like, well, what's all this about? So he goes, you know, they're not good for anyone, you know, the stupid thing to get into. And we're like, yeah, we know. And he went, you know, do you? He said, yeah. He said, what's this then? And he'd found something in his bedroom. And it was a Skittle.
What, the sweet?
Do you know, little sweets with the S on it.
And oh, really?
Drugs.
Yeah.
So he said, well, yeah, it's a Skittle. Yeah, I know what it is.
Oh, he was bluffing like that as a slang word.
Yeah, he thought because he was a copper, he probably had to be down with all the terms and that. So we said, oh, it's a Skittle. And he said, yeah, yeah, I know what it is. But what's it doing in your bedroom?
Oh.
It was like, no, it's a toffee. So, Darren, man.
Yeah, I know, it's a toffee. It's a squib. It's a, yeah.
Carl, more people from your past. Debbie Carr?
Yeah, she was another nice one.
What does that mean? Is that a euphemism?
No, she was one of them that you'd sort of go, she's nice, but she'd never be your girlfriend. Do you know what I mean? She was
not really.
Even though she was in the same year, she seemed a lot older.
Right.
And like, wasn't a teacher, was it?
There was three of them who all hung together, and they seemed to hang around like the older kids, the ones who looked like men. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. What did you look like then?
Well, it's just that I had youthful sort of looks, whereas like the older ones had like beards and stuff.
It's a gang of boys in the fifth form with beers. Were they smoking pipes? Going, come over here, me filly. Oi, you, Debbie Carr, come over here, you little beauty.
No, but she was like...
I love that. Hanging around with beers, there's the big boys. Oh, fishing. That's lovely beers.
I just see a whole row of George Bernard Shaws.
Brilliant. How do you do in history, boy? Yeah. They got an E. You're an idiot.
Oh. They were like, you know, I'd be there sort of... playing, punching people in the arm.
That's a great game.
Oh, I love that, punching people in the arm.
Is that part of the Olympics now?
I think it was exhibition this year.
Right.
But
it's going to be a pro next year.
It's going to be the Winter Olympics, because you've got to do it in just a cap sleeve shirt in winter. Yeah.
So you're playing that.
She, but whilst
but
I
But she didn't appreciate that. She used to go, ow!
No, I always think, whilst I was doing that, they were like the Charlie's Angels, and they'd be sorting out a mission somewhere. Because they were really like, there was something about them. But yeah. He thought, you know, well, yeah, first, special.
They were probably detectives.
What if they work for a man they never see?
Okay, well, here's a name I'm interested in, because, well, let me just tell you the name first. Adam Clifton.
Hmm.
Oh. Go on, what are your thoughts on Clifton?
He was one of them kids, he was alright, but he had that thing when, if you didn't have enough milk. He had, like, wrinkly hands, and... white bits in his nails.
Because you didn't have enough milk.
Yeah.
So therefore, you didn't like him because you didn't get enough milk.
This is not to be confused with the two people with the big heads and the webbed feet, is it?
Webbed hands.
Well, this was they weren't related. They must have been somewhere along the evolutionary sort of trail, do you know what I mean? They must have come from the same sort of stock.
But no, you wouldn't have liked him. It's just one of them people. He was all right, but...
Before you say any more, on Friends United, you can leave a little message which explains what you've been doing and your life's like now. And most people leave maybe two paragraphs. Right. Adam, I've printed it off. He seems to have printed... I think there's about six pages here of stuff. He keeps updating it. And he just basically lists his memories about everyone, okay, at the school and what he thinks of everyone. And he says, I often see Simon, da-da-da-da, he's doing all right for himself, self-employed illustrator, Mark Cooper, Carl Pilkington.
Right.
And your name comes up. Now, I don't know if you've told us this story. I think you may have done, but I can't remember the facts about it. It just says, Carl Pilkington, with his pet bird, was it a magpie? I can't remember. He brought it to school to show everyone, and it flew away.
Oh, God! Oh, no, they do that, don't they?
What was the story there,
Carl? You give them seeds and they just leave. What do you mean?
Well, this sounds like Kez.
Well, that's it. I was a big fan of Kez. And it was the time our dog had just died.
Yeah.
So I didn't have any pets and the cats were always getting run over.
Yeah.
And so we didn't want any more pets.
Yeah.
But there was a magpie that used to fly about on the estate and I managed to sort of tame it. And in the end...
With a chair and a whip? What do you mean you tamed it?
Well, just used to sort of hang around it and talk.
But how did you get hold of it? Did you catch it?
Well, eventually, yeah, it used to just come to me. And the annoying thing was, it got to a point when I wish I hadn't bothered. Because it used to pop me bike tyres. It used to sit on like, if I was talking to my mates and I was on my grifter.
I love the way he just throws things in.
It's like an Alan Bennett play.
It landed on my tyre, and it used to peck at the tyre and pop it, and then it used to then never go away, so it was always, like, around the house, and my dad said never bring it in. So it used to sit on the porch, and I used to go out, and it used to fly down and land on my head, and it really hurt. It used to, like, peck and stuff.
He thought it was a tyre.
So it wasn't so much tamed as a stalker.
Oh, God!
So you took it to school and it flew away?
Yeah.
So did you take it in proudly, going, look at my magpie? Oh!
Yeah.
Oh,
but,
no.
I think it got a bit confused in the area that it was in, because I used to just keep it sort of around our estate, but the school was a bit of a distance away.
How did you get it there?
Carrying it on my finger.
Did you walk?
Yeah.
Wow.
So it was happy there, and then it got...
But it used to be one of those things that people would stop me in the street and sort of go, oh, what's that? Called it Maggie.
You didn't get Charlie's Angels to go and find out what happened to it? Investigate?
Were they impressed?
Not really.
A few more names that you may recall from Friends Reunited.
Go on.
Lisa Shufflebotham? Do you remember her?
Yeah, she,
Was she one of Charlie's Angels?
No, she wasn't that nice, but she wanted me. her and her mate Rachel, I remember, I don't know why, but it was some sort of PE lesson where it had to be a bloke and two girls, and they were fighting over me.
Could you hear what they were saying?
They were just like, I want him, and I was loving it. Stuck in the middle, and they were fighting over me, and then the next week I thought, I'll sit near them.
What sort of game do they play at this school?
I don't know.
That's an incredible game.
But I think
punch me on the arm. No, punch me on the arm, Carl.
They just went through it. Because the following week I thought, right, I'll sit near them again because I quite enjoyed the way they fighted over me. But then they picked somebody else and, I don't know, who I was with that week.
So you didn't get any action with Shufflebotham or a friend?
No. And then as she got older, she went a bit off. She didn't look that good. She's probably nice now. It's just, I mean, I'll say about myself, when you get to sort of the end of secondary school, you do sort of go a bit odd looking.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? When your sort of head grows funny.
I would just love to go back to his school of that era. I mean, just what happened to people, whether, you know, all people sprouting limbs and
things. No, do you know what
things?
I mean? When you're like 12 and that, you're quite... No, not 12. When you're 10. When you're 7 to 10, you sort of look healthy, and you look at your pictures when you go, yeah, I was a good-looking lad. But then when you get to late secondary school, something happens.
Yeah.
And you just look a bit odd.
Okay, well, what about Alison Thorpe?
Not sure about her. I sort of know the name, can't put a face to it.
Damien Comer?
Again, know the name.
Yeah.
Can't remember anything.
No.
Yeah.
It's a shame. Well, these are pretty much all the names I could find. We've had some interesting thoughts, though, and interesting anecdotes.
Yeah.
Anyone in particular that you'd like to say hello to that maybe listening now that
no,
you-
No, I think I would have mentioned Darren Buckley if you hadn't brought him up.
Oh, right.
He was like me buddy.
Yeah. Yeah. Did you ever see the, Magpie game when you took it to the school and confused it?
No.
You're joking, that was the end of it, was it?
Yeah.
So where did it go?
Probably, to some other kid. Cause I mean, actually it probably got killed. Cause if it was being that friendly with other people, some people might have took advantage of it.
In what way?
Well, there was a programme on the other week about-
What, in the way that Shuffle both of them was trying to take advantage of you?
Well, there was a programme on the other week about bear whisperers.
Yeah.
And, some blokes got really friendly with a bear, and then when they were leaving that area where the bear was, they said, oh, we've caused a problem here, because there's some bear hunters coming in and moving into this area, and it's gonna get a bullet if it acts like this, so they had to scare it away, and that's what I should have done with Maggie. I should have terrified it a little bit, so it wouldn't trust humans.
No. Just introduced it to some of your schoolmates, I'm sure, would have freaked it right out.
Well, the ones
maybe that was
heads.
Why it fled.
It didn't see those two fellas with big heads and webbed hands coming towards it, did it?
That would have terrified anything. It's like a scarecrow, like two walking scarecrows.
Express 2 featuring David Byrne, Lazy, XFM 104.9, 1:45, I'm Ricky Gervais, Steve's got the sun.
Yes, I'm just
we're just going to be doing White Van Carl, where we ask Carl the questions the sun asked some other bloke.
That's right.
Because we think Carl's got more to say than anyone on anything. Sure. Carl only tells the truth, by the way. Just remember that, listeners. Off you go.
Yes, well, today's White Van Man in the Sun is John Slade. He owns his own door maintenance company. his answers are very informative, I have to say. But Carl, what do you make of, the Channel 4 producer, aged 30, who duped a school into believing he was a teenager? For a documentary, are you familiar with this story?
No, go on.
Well, basically a 30-year-old guy kind of fooled the school into thinking he was a pupil for a secret documentary. The school's outraged. Do you think that that's, you know, for you, you know, should anything go when it comes to making TV?
I think I've said to you before, there's loads of kids at my school. I remember being in the first year, and kids who, what year do schools go up to? I was in the first year, what is it?
11.
5.
Oh, sorry, first year of infants and juniors.
No, secondary school.
11.
Right, year 11. Kids
no,
have beards and
no,
stuff.
No, not year 11. They're 11 when they first go to secondary school.
Right, well I'm 11, the kid's at the older
well,
end.
Well, there's a fifth form and then there's
you can leave when you can leave when you're 16, I think, can't you now?
Right, well kids who were 16
yeah.
looked old. They had they did have beards. I remember going there and thinking some of them were teachers.
I think he's answered that. Next one, what's the next one?
Tattoos and everything. I think kids in the earlier years, even.
What do you make of the fact that Mariah Carey's £38 million payoff has cost EMI staff their jobs, and we're talking 1,800 EMI staff who have lost their jobs.
What do you think of that?
Yeah, I mean,
is that silly money, Mariah Carey, on 38 million?
She doesn't need that much.
She doesn't need that much. She has to dress nice, though.
It's not her fault. I'd say, it's bad business.
Okay.
Because, EMI, did you say?
Yes.
Right. They've got rid of them staff.
Yeah.
Mariah Carey's left. Who's gonna do the work?
do you think Mariah should come back and do some temping?
Well, they should have got a loan and paid her.
Okay.
Do you know what I mean? Vicious circle, that.
Right.
Have you done a business degree, only, have you?
Commerce.
You did commerce? Yeah. Where did you do that? What did you do that?
At school, I'd learn how to fill out a cheque. Pay a bill, and, I think I had a trip round Kellogg's.
Did you get an O level or GCSE?
We know he didn't.
You know.
But was there a commerce exam or was it just a division of maths?
Remember.
What did he fill out a check?
Was it a subset of
it
maths.
It was an option. It was like if you want to do it, you can.
What
do.
Was it? Fill out a check. Pay a bill.
Have a visit round Kellogg's.
Round Kellogg's, and I saw my sister's boyfriend there at the time. He sorted me out with some variety packs.
Really? What was in them?
You know, Rice Krispies and
good stuff.
Cocoa Pops.
Space. Dust or whatever it is.
Space dust!
So, sorry, that wasn't Ken Dodd, no.
No.
That was someone else, wasn't it? That was an aunt.
Yeah. That wasn't Special K.
What do you make of fears that dumped Britney Spears, she's been dumped by her boyfriend, there's worries that she may be cracking up, Carl?
What,
you concerned?
What are the signs?
I'm not entirely sure. I'm just reading from this section, but I would assume that she's obviously showed signs of depression, maybe?
She'll be alright. I remember, like, you know, Zoe Harris, when she sort of got bored of me when I was a kid.
Yeah.
Get over it, I don't even think about her now.
and how long did it take you, to get over
Zoe Harris?
How long did it take
to be honest, right, it was like one of my first girlfriends, and she was a pain. I remember, I went out with her, because she wouldn't stop hassling me, right?
Yeah.
I remember-
Good reason, I love that. Oh, go on then.
I never talked to her, and then, the bit that really got me, I thought I half liked her, and then I remember, right, we're at a school party, sort of infant school.
Infant school?
Right.
Are you sure it wasn't junior school?
Well, it's on the cusp.
Yeah.
Right, when you're about to leave infants and go to the next one.
Yeah.
And, she was crying.
You were saying, I don't think we should move in together.
She was crying. Oh, was she?
Had you stolen her milk?
She was nearly six. Why didn't she grow up?
No, so she was crying because somebody had stood on a dress and put a bit of an hole in it. And I said, oh, for God's sake.
I can't stand it. Oh, so God. You I just think of him.
So you gave her a slap.
I just think of him, like, six, like, with clogs and a flat cap, going slightly bald, going, for Christ's sake, woman, come on.
Oh. Light my pipe.
Oh. I finished it, because all her mates were saying, come on, Carl, she's upset, and I was like, oh, whatever.
Hold on, though. Wait a minute. What do you mean all the mates were saying, like, come on, Carl? They were six, weren't they?
Yeah, but they were saying, come on, she's crying. Help her out.
And, like, and you did nothing?
I don't know.
She got injured. Got a hole in her skirt.
Yeah, but she was upset and you were her boyfriend.
Well.
So what did you do? Tell me the story. Where were you?
Didn't work out.
You were at some kind of school do. There was a hole
in
her dress.
It didn't work out, he said.
Do you treat your current girlfriend in the same way? This callous disregard for someone's
feelings? His current girlfriend does not tread on her dress. Does she?
Huh.
Oh, she didn't.
So, as far as you're concerned, what was her name? Sarah?
Zoe.
Zoe Harris. You just felt like, well, you know, she's going to make a whinge about, you know, a silly little hole. Screw her.
Yeah.
You're all heart, Carl.
What would you have done?
I'd have gone over there and give her a lovely kiss.
No, you wouldn't.
Yes, I would.
We were playing Dead Arm.
If you had hair, what would it be like?
What do you mean?
Well, you obviously had hair then, back then. What was the, style?
It was like, sort of, I had quite sort of, fine, sort of straight hair.
Yeah.
Right.
Hairdresser once said to me, you've got hair of a Chinaman.
He was a wise man, wasn't he? What do you think that meant then? Oh!
He just said you've got the same hair as a Chinese man has. Very straight, quite fine,
Why is he doing it? I just imagine this bar going,
the arsehole did well, didn't it, sir? Should I have something on that? You have the hair of a Chinaman. I'm sorry, nothing. You're not the spy. No, I'm not. Thank you. Good night.
Yeah,
lovely. You have the feet of a fish. I'm sorry, nothing. It's not you. Okay, next. You have the hair of a Chinaman.
It was one of those barbers, it was a cheap one, just on a railway bridge.
I don't believe that. Go on.
On a railway bridge?
That's why it was cheap. It was very low rent, so he could charge
50p. That wasn't a barber, that was a man with some scissors.
Yeah. Did you go, oh, have to move you there, sir? Yeah.
Okay, back in the chair, sir.
Now I imagine them on one of those things you always see in old films where you've got
you have to press down and down again, like a seesaw.
Yeah.
That's not as good as that. It was just a normal chair, little wooden hut. And he did have to stop when a train came past, because he used to-
Well, because he had to change the signal.
Just making a few extra miles.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Oh, I love
that's
that.
That's Manchester for you.
Oh, God.
I always
it wasn't Bernard Cribbins, was it?
I always remember him saying, do you want your hair washing? And I said, is it free? You know, does it come with it? And he said, yeah. So I said, oh, go on then. He said, hang on now, I'll just have to wash these mugs up. He had like a sink full of mugs.
Oh, God.
So I'll
God.
Just take these out and then I can wash your head.
Oh, no.
And that's why.
Why did you go to this man?
It was cheap.
It was How much was it?
About £2.
And when was this?
God. At 88, 89.
All right.
Yeah.
So what happened to your Chinese hair? When did it start coming out?
You have the hair of a bald Chinaman now, don't you?
You've got the hair of a Chinaman in a box now.
Oh. I used to just, work a lot of hours, and I think...
That's what made it fall out.
Yeah, of course.
It's not. It's genetic. You can't stop
it's not
it,
genetic.
Of course it is.
Your dad bald?
No, it's got more hair than me now, I think.
Is your mum? Kojak's got more hair than you, Carl.
Anyway, don't have a go at Carl's hair, that's a bit harsh.
Oh, look at his little face.
What did it say before in that book about going bald? It said, it had a little tip, didn't it? We'll go over them later.
It says, if you're going thin, doesn't it say, cut your hair short and something like that?
So it makes you look thicker. I've never been into getting presents and that. I had the problem at that Christmas one, that time with the Victoria Plum.
Yeah, we'd hate that. We'd hate to bring that back.
We've done that.
Because you talked about the book, because it's kind of to do with your dad, isn't it? He's a very bad gift buyer, was that the problem?
Well, yeah, my dad just wouldn't bother. It was my mum who sort of made an effort, and she sort of worked out half of what I wanted, then she left it to my dad to get it off someone, see if he could get one cheap or whatever.
I love the fact that usually people talk about, like, drinking heavily, yeah, or violent abuse, right? Yeah. But here's what he's been left with and scarred with from parents is bad gift buying.
Yeah, and that's the Victoria Plum incident.
In the greatest scheme of things in the world, yeah, that's not a bad thing to have, is it?
Right, this is what it's like about getting presents and stuff, right? Mm. With me mum and dad.
Go on.
My mate, Colin, right? Colin Bailey.
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
He had a, little, Sinclair Spectrum, right? Yeah. Computer. Yeah. Which was, like, the thing to have at that time, right? Yeah. Used to always go round to his house.
Not the one you had to play through the window, because you weren't allowed
to. No, that's another lad.
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
This is a different lad. And the deal was, he came to our house, and my mum gave him a pie. And then I'd go round to his, and I'd stay there for a few hours playing, you know, Hungry Oris and stuff like that on it.
Sure. Right?
Now, my mum and dad knew that I really wanted one of these computers, right? So I waited about a year. Came round to Christmas Day, I thought, I reckon I might have one. Turned out, they bought me the wrong one. They bought me a ZX81 instead of a Spectrum, right? And Christmas Day, I'm there trying to load the games up. It's not working. I'm thinking, what's wrong? Right? And the thing with me, when I was a kid, I used to get quite sort of agitated.
This is the moment.
Right? I found out that he needed a RAM pack to make it work. Right? Looking in the thing and it's saying, and make sure you put your RAM pack in the back. And I was like, oh, where's the RAM pack? And my dad's going, I don't know, I've got you the main bit. That's it. So, I was that wound up. I just was sick, right? Just sick. Oh, I didn't feel sick or anything, I just was like, oh god. Went to the sink, just sick. Cause I was that on edge about it. I said, come on, we've gotta get one. And my dad's like, Tandy's shut, we're not gonna get anything today. Ruined again, Christmas Day. That was after the year when my train set got blown up by our kid. The following year, no RAM pack. And now you ask me, why don't I get good presents?
He's scarred. I'm gonna die.
He's just being sick.
Yeah.
There's no RAM pack. Did you get to the bottom of it? Why wasn't there a RAM pack?
You have to buy them separate.
Oh, right, okay.
What do you mean I can't play Frogger?
Oh, no.
So, wasn't there another incident when you threw up? Spontaneously threw up?
Oh.
Through sheer anxiety?
I do get it. It's not so much now, because I've relaxed a bit, but as a kid, I used to be quite on edge all the time with certain things.
Do you think that's what happened to your
cat? Wind that kept being sick. That it didn't get the food it wanted. And it just threw up. Do you remember that?
Yeah, yeah.
God. So they shaved it.
Yeah, but again, you see, the cat thing. I mean, it's mad. I was thinking about it the other day, right? I used to think I had quite a normal upbringing.
He didn't.
Right? And someone was talking
about
the cat.
Your mother once told you not to go to school because it was windy, Carl. It was not a normal upbringing.
The cat was being sick, so she shaved it, so it was easier to clean.
Right, well, my mum and dad went on holiday, right? And I stayed at the Rosses down the road.
Oh, yeah.
Only a kid. Must have been about five or something, right? And, I was always running around in the house. I had a lot of energy as a kid. What the Rosses did, they had this cat that was dead violent. The most violent sort of angry cat I have ever witnessed.
A tiger.
It was honestly, Steve, if it was bigger, it would have been, because it was just always having a go at you.
Yeah.
If you went to pat it on the head, it went to bite you and stuff. And what they used to do with it, to stop me running around, I'd sort of be running around, and then I'd get a bit tired, and they'd say, have a lie down on the settee. So I'd lie down on the settee and I'd nod off, and what they used to do, I'd wake up, and they'd have put the cat on my belly. Right? So, I'd be scared to move, because it's like it's gonna get me.
But it would keep you there.
It kept me there, and it used to sort of slaver on me, and they'd sort of, you know, go out or whatever, and I'd be lying there. That's not normal, is it?
Carl, sorry, were you created by the Brothers Grimm for one of their fairy tales? What kind of a life is that?